I am Dr. Holla. I joined this institution from the very inception, that means in 1961, and I have been working here since then without any break. Before joining here, I can mention here that I was serving in the Indian Army as Professor of Medicine in Armed Forces Medical College and Senior Advisor in Medicine for the Armed Forces. Now, after having joined this institution, I have the privilege of serving and seeing spectrum of cases presenting in Bangalore in general and in this locality in particular. Now, today being this week being the immunization week, I can mention few things about the immunization required in adults. Adults means normally immunization is done after the age of 60 or 65. Anybody can have this, truly speaking, all people above the age of 60 or 65 should take these immunization injections, particularly those people who suffer from chronic lung diseases like asthma, bronchial asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, bronchiectasis, etc. People with allergy and recurrent bronchitis. They are the people who are prone to these the lung infections, and they should take these injections with the great benefit. Now, the two injections are available. One is for the influenza, which has to be taken once a year. The other injection is mainly for pneumococcal infection of the lung, which is very common in elderly people, and this is one injection for the whole life. And this injection is polyvalent. It also covers infections for other organisms. So these two injections, by and large, protect the individual for the rest of his life, the later one. And the first one, influenza, the injection can be taken as and when there is an epidemic. Otherwise, no need to take it every year. If there are local cases, I think the person should take it once a year. Now, the advantage of taking these immunization injections are that the morbidity and mortality amongst elderly people is curtailed to a great extent. And these injections also prevent the spread of infection from one person to other, thereby curtailing the incidence of these infections in the society. The other immunization injections or program for adults include those diseases where the prevalence is high in a given society. For example, if there is an incidence of typhoid or gastroenteritis, see, the immunization should concentrate on those diseases which are prevalent amongst the people living in the society. That depends on which infection is present at a given time. That I think is enough. That's one.
Message
to the society and the population is that we normally forget to take these preventive measures, especially in adult peoples who are also not in a mood to take these injections quite often. We must persuade the elderly people, especially elderly people, to take these injections and the immunization, the injections, so that during the later part of their life, their health remains normal and enjoyable. Okay? Mm-hmm.